Hi, I'm Ebby Mohseni for Tri-City Magazine. On Wednesday, May 23rd, 2012, from 4 to 8 p.m., an event has been held as the Riverview Lands Community Values Workshop by the BC Provincial Government at the North Road Executive Plaza Hotel. Government of British Columbia provided opportunity to the citizens to write their own opinion on 10 pages of questionnaires and a page of comment at four stations.
My name is Joe Trostellini. I reside in Port Moody, and I'm the MLA for Port Moody Coquitlam Riding, which of course includes the villages of Anmore and Belcarra. I'm here today as a Tri-Cities resident a lot of interest about the Riverview Lands. I'm here to take a look at the display in this workshop and of course express my thoughts about the heritage, historical and social values of this great piece of land with a lot of history in this area and of great significance to mental health facilities for the region, in fact. So this is a process where information is being gathered by members of the community.
So I'm glad to have had the opportunity to investigate some of the ideas for what they want to do with the Riverview Lands, and I really believe it's an iconic property. It's one of the last remaining large properties in the region. Oakland's prison was one of those lands, and it's fully redeveloped now. There's some property left at Deer Lake. The Woodland Lands are gone, they've been redeveloped. The BC Penn Lands are gone, they've been redeveloped. And so this Riverview property now is one of the last large river bottom properties left in the area. And I just think that it's worth preserving. It has a wonderful heritage. I think it's still a place of health and of refreshment. And I think, yeah, it'd be good. Keep it.
It's like having a relative.
I'm Sue Haverty with the Riverview Horticultural Center Society. And I'm here with our esteemed president, Norma Gillespie. We are celebrating our 20th anniversary this year. For 20 years, we've been fighting for a decent future for the Riverview Lands and the trees that are there and the buildings that are there. And are we getting anywhere? Damn it, I hope so. What do you think, Norma?
Oh, I got it. That the good guys are going to win this one.
We certainly have. Anyway, what are we doing here today? Well, the province of British Columbia owns the land, and I think, I'm not sure, you have to ask somebody else why this all happened, but this is a heritage conservation plan public meeting, and they're spending big bucks to find out what people value about the Riverview Lands and why. So we're here to tell them. Now, this has been done before, actually, and a lot of money has been spent, and I think they probably got the message, but we'll give it to them one more time. You have anything to add?
Well, we're a little concerned that the people haven't been given enough time, enough notice on the meetings coming up. That's been a concern from the beginning. I believe that the group that is in charge for the government of organizing this realizes the concern and perhaps will add meetings, and they will maybe go on through into the fall, because it's very hard to get people out to events like this.
Well, we would like to invite everybody to come to Riverview on June the 3rd. That's a Sunday, right, Norma?
That's June the 3rd.
And that is our celebration of our 20th anniversary. We're hoping for good weather. The trees will be glorious, and we're having an anniversary party, which involves tea.
Well, yes.
Refreshments.
Tea all day long.
And we'll have a look at the heritage at Riverview, because really it's kind of stupid for us to be here in a hotel room when we're talking about a place that, if you are there, you absolutely are captivated by the place. But this is a problem with us, because we know that when people go to Riverview, and it's public land, you can drive through it, you can go there, you can walk around, you can enjoy it, you will be amazed. And when people go there and they see it, they never think about it in the same way.
Is there any tour going on?
There are tours, yes. We have tree walks. Our website is very simple, rhcs.org, and there's lots of information up there about dates of tree tours coming up this summer, and RT, and Tree Fest, which is a big community festival there. And so if anybody's watching out there, you got to go to Riverview. You've
June
got to go there on June 3rd or any time at all.
Is it the Sunday?
It will be a Sunday, yes. June 3rd is a Sunday. But yes. If you can't go then, go another time.
Is there any possibility for people to get inside the Heritage Building and being amazed at what...
You should talk to the managers here. There's the guy right there. We haven't been successful in getting inside buildings. So why don't you ask him?
We have asked, and we haven't been granted permission yet, but we have asked if we could get into East Lawn. So we're keeping our fingers crossed. But events will start at 11 o'clock on June the 3rd. And we're at this time, we're looking at a question and answer period. And then the walks will start about 1 and 2. 2 o'clock.
Yes. What time do you close it?
Well, 4 or until people get tired.
My name is Marcia McClellan, and I have a son currently at Cypress Lodge on the Riverview grounds, and I've been involved with Riverview for many, many years. I belong to the Riverview Preservation Society, and our goal is to see the remaining 244 acres preserved and the mentally ill treated on these grounds. We'd like to see the grounds remain green space for the mentally ill. The new plan to treat the mentally ill at UBC Hospital and in the future to be treated at Willow Pavilion is extremely short-sighted, unfair, and it lacks significantly. The majority of patients that have left Riverview in the past are currently in the downtown east side, where they don't receive medication, they live in squalor filth, and they're dying premature deaths. We would like to see Riverview restored to a mental health facility so that the mentally ill patients or the mentally ill people suffering from severe mental illness can have their dignity restored and be treated as equal members of society. And so we would encourage all people that are interested in seeing Riverview preserved for the mentally ill, and I would say by and large the population that wants to see that is very significant. Most people believe that Riverview should be for the mentally ill, and that includes business people that are dealing with mentally ill on their doorsteps, that includes bus drivers that are not trained to deal with the mentally ill, the police are frustrated, and it's so unkind and unfair. Canada is supposed to be a civilized society. Let's save Riverview, get the mentally ill treated, housing, you know, for the addicted, the homeless mentally ill. Let's restore Riverview and restore dignity to the mentally ill. The hospitals now are not taking in a lot of severely mentally ill people to be treated. They're being discharged prematurely. We don't know how many deaths this has resulted in. I personally knew of a young man that was discharged prematurely, and he ended up taking his life. And it's just vital that we keep Riverview for the mentally ill, keep the grounds. This is their sanctuary. This gives them a hope that they can have a future. So save Riverview for the whole province.
My name's Elaine Gold, and I'm with the Burke Mountain Naturalists in Coquitlam. We've been engaged in trying to preserve the Riverview site for about 20 years, and we just think it is an absolute jewel. It's a center for mental health care, and it still should be, although the last of the patients will be leaving this summer. It's a great shame. It's got a world-class collection of trees. It's got beautiful heritage buildings. And the way that it was designed so that the patients would have a close contact with nature. They would get nutritious food, some of which they grew on their own at Colony Farm. And they would have meaningful tasks to do, such as doing the gardening and the horticulture. And they would receive training and so on. That was a really good concept 100 years ago, and it's still a really good concept. And that's what we should be going back to. I've been really upset to see, for example, the Valley View Hospital at Riverview be closed, because that hospital was designed to treat patients with dementia. And it's not been replaced. There's now a critical shortage of beds for patients like that, and yet we have empty buildings at Riverview. That just doesn't make sense. Riverview is also a really important green part of a green corridor. It connects Mundy Park to Riverview Forest down to Colony Farm. And we also need to maintain that link. Riverview is a great place just to go for a walk. Everyone feels mentally more healthy once they've been on a walk through the Riverview grounds. So we have to keep it, because it's a very precious place the way that it is. But we do need to bring the patients back. It should become a center for mental wellness. And we will all benefit by having Riverview used in that way.
My name is Jane Shoemaker and I live in Coquitlam. I am overcome with shame at the way we have been treating mentally ill people in the last couple of decades. We see these people destitute, wandering the streets, unable to cope with living in a regular society. They take up beds in hospitals that are needed for other types of beds, and in these hospitals they don't receive the appropriate treatment. Historically, Riverview was a wonderful place where people like this could live. We have to abandon this newfangled idea of getting people out of so-called institutions. We do have the intelligence, we have the experts who can design, using some of the historical methods, ways for people like this to live in a healthy place like Riverview. It's accepted everywhere that nature is a great, is a way that people can access, can build mental health in themselves. It's a comforting sanctuary to be among the trees and the gardens. It's even better if they're able to garden themselves. And people living here used to develop a wonderful sense of community. They could feel safe here. They were cared for. People made sure they took their medications and gave them what they needed. People, mentally ill people these days need these same resources, and we can give them what they need within a so-called institution, which has become a bad word. We can make it a good word again. Another treasure within the Riverview Lands is the wonderful collection of trees that was put together many decades ago. And you can't see these trees anywhere else. It's a wonderful arboretum for people all over the community to come and visit and enjoy. At one time, my mother was a patient at Riverview Hospital. She received very good care, and we were grateful. Thank you.
I'm a resident in the general vicinity of Riverview Hospital, and I have been there for almost 40 years now. And my opinion on the Riverview Lands is that it should not be, I say should not be, for mental health. The reason being is that I was born here in New Westminster 77 years ago, And the Riverview Hospital was the general feeling of what people did in those days with the mentally incapacitated people. They were put in a closet or as far away from everybody as could be. So they built Riverview out where the fog and the rain are predominant. And that is not good for mental health, in my opinion. I think these people should be treated far better, where they can grow a garden. In Riverview, you're lucky to get one crop every 4 years. In Delta, you get one bad crop every 4 years as a comparison. So that is, it makes people feel better if they can do something along those lines. Rain, fog, well, the fog is not as bad as it was when I was young, that's for sure, but it still is a foggy, drizzly, wet place, and for mental health, to me, that is absolutely the wrong thing to do. They should be someplace in Cloverdale, Langley, White Rock, where there's a lot more sunshine and where they can do outdoor things, perhaps have a few animals that are very good for people in this position. That is my opinion.
My name is Norma Leto, and I am a Coquitlam resident for more than 45 years. I'm concerned about what's going on with Riverview Lands, because we have had many meetings with the government expressing the interest of Coquitlam residents to preserve the Riverview Lands. And not exactly sure what they would be used for, but my personal opinion is that they should stay as some sort of treatment and educational center for mental health issues. I'm looking at the demographics of our population, and we are going to have a lot of older people, and my grandmother had Alzheimer's, and I saw what that was like for our family. I think that research into treatments would be very, very good, and the society would benefit in general. One thing that happens with people who have Alzheimer's is they become unable to look after themselves by feeding themselves and doing basic things. If you have to have outreach workers going to everyone's home, that's very difficult. And the general understanding from our government currently is that baby boomers generally don't have any pensions, and the times are less affluent now and will be in the future. And I'm concerned of what's going to happen to all these older people who are unable to look after themselves and are mentally deteriorating. It's quite possible that they could be in their homes and get very, very ill before someone discovers them, and then be taken to the hospital where they're treated, of course, but they might have to have a lengthy stay at a hospital, which will cost tremendous amounts of money and will put a great pressure on our social system. So it may be a good idea to think of how we're going to deal with these potential problems now.
Hello, I'm Terry O'Neill. I'm a city councillor in Coquitlam, and I'm very pleased to be taking part in the process to start the ball rolling towards the big decision on what's going to become of the Riverview Lands. And I want to talk about, I like working with old expressions, and I want to be able to have our cake and eat it too when it comes to the Riverview Lands. And by that I mean to try to protect all the values that are important to Coquitlam: the preservation of the green space, the preservation of the unique collection of trees, and some of the historical values of the old, grand old buildings that are there, while at the same time finding some sort of productive future use for those, for the area. So it becomes an asset not only to Coquitlam, but for the whole of British Columbia, because it's a provincial land and it's an asset for the province. So regardless of what the province ultimately decides to do with the built with the lands, whether to reinstitute some sort of facility for the mentally ill and mentally challenged, or whether or not to have some medical facility, or whether or not, as they've talked about in the past, there's some sort of residential development goes in there. How can we have that and preserve the values that so many people in Coquitlam, including myself, would like to save? And I think we can work towards that, and this is what I've been talking about in this meeting that we just finished having. And so there's a couple of elements that have to be put in place there, and then one of them is to work within the existing footprint of the existing buildings. I think that's very important, because that would preserve the green space and the trees, and it's something even the provincial government has talked about, how important it is to preserve those trees. So regardless of whether the buildings are renovated or whether there's new buildings that go into some of those structures to work within the footprints of those buildings. It's a sort of a strategy that's in place in Europe and has been for many years as they redevelop centuries-old parts of old cities, working within those footprints. I think that's very important to do that. So you can work within a footprint and keep the existing buildings, building size there, or you can build new buildings. Now, how do you do that and preserve the heritage value of some of the buildings too? Well, I know that there's a classic examples all over the world of saving important facades of buildings. So people driving on Lougheed Highway, looking up the hill, they still see that beautiful sort of red brick or something like that that they've grown used to saving. But in behind that, perhaps there's a new building, a new structure of some sort that's attached to that on the existing footprint of the old building, where there's a new health facility of some sort, maybe residential. I don't know, and I'm not going to presume to try to guess. But so that way we preserve the sort of values that I think are very important to Coquitlam residents. Again, we're preserving the general green space and the openness of the area. That's a beautiful area. We're preserving the trees, and we're also preserving the heritage value where we can of the buildings themselves, and turning the place into something that's a real asset. And that's my position. Of course, I appreciate and value people who are living with a mental illness. I view every human life as precious, and just because there's some sort of a disability, mental or physical, it doesn't mean that we devalue that person's life or don't appreciate their existence. We look for ways to support, and we look for ways that they can contribute as well. One of the best ways of helping people who are suffering from addiction problems or health problems of some sort is to find ways to engage them in our community so they can feel useful.
Yes.
And certainly if they're locked away in a big institution or something as they used to do, besides the odd workshop, I think there's a lot of people didn't feel very useful. So I think that with sort of the modern drug regimes that we have, that is possible now, and I've seen evidence of that. So that's very important for people.
You mean the possibility of people with mental illness can be productive somehow? I mean, some people maybe almost 100%, some people less or more.
Yeah. Well, and that's not just an economic thing that I'm saying. Well, they got to earn money to pay taxes to support government. That's for their souls.
Yes.
You know, that's to make them feel important and worthwhile, because you and I know that unless you're doing something productive, and you're not going to be feeling as good about yourself, right? And it's very important to do that sort of stuff. So you have the sense of accomplishment, the sense of engagement that's so important in our lives here. And why we feel that way, I don't know. But that's the way human beings are made up. And so I'd like to make sure that we have policies in place that facilitate that sort of positive outcome. I think we're on the right track right now in terms of what we're doing with Riverview, that there is some consultation going on, albeit at quite a quick rate. And all of this happens under the umbrella of Christy Clark saying last year that she's going to follow the local lead, which is very important. I know that I've got colleagues on council who are very involved in this, and we hear from the public a lot on this. It's an important issue. So I believe we're going to do the right thing. And but again, I'm talking about we. It's we as a society, really, that's important here. It's not city council won't be deciding. But I don't think the provincial government is going to make this decision in isolation either. I think that they've got their eyes and their ears wide open, and it's good that they're listening and seeing.
My name's Craig Hodge. I'm a councillor in the city of Coquitlam, and I chair the city's Riverview Lands Advisory Committee. And today, this is the second of two workshops that are being held, and the subject of these workshops is the Heritage Conservation Plan. And so a group has been put together by the provincial government through their Shared Services Division, and they're seeking public input into what the heritage value is to the people in the area. And so we're here today, we're learning about what people's thoughts are on the buildings, the lands, the trees, and in some cases things that aren't quite as tangible as structures. So this is the first step in determining what the use of the lands could ultimately be. And so the Heritage Conservation Plan that's underway right now is an important part of that process. And, you know, the Riverview Lands have been part of our community here in Coquitlam for over 100 years. The first building was built in 1913. So basically 100 years ago next year will be the anniversary of the start of Riverview. At one time there were 1,000 acres. It's currently down to 244 acres, and it's served primarily as a facility for mental health over that period. And at one time there were 4,500 patients housed on the Riverview lands, and 2,000 people worked on the grounds. And it was a small city within our city. It had its own post office, its own fire hall, schools, and many of the people who worked on the grounds lived on the grounds. And so there's a great deal of history to the site, and it's I think it's a site that's important to not just the people who live in Coquitlam today, but to many residents throughout the Lower Mainland. And we're hoping that we're going to get a chance to hear from them about what this site means to them.
I'm Margaret McDermott. I'm the Minister of Labour, Citizen Services and Open Government, and we're talking about the Riverview Lands. There is a memorandum of understanding between the Ministry of Citizen Services and the Ministry, actually it's Mines and Energy now, but it's the Ministry where housing is within government. The agreement that we have is that the future land use planning will be done by the Minister who's responsible for housing. But we own these lands and manage these lands, the Ministry of Citizen Services. And so, as I think most people are aware, the Riverview lands for many, many years, probably over 100 years, have been a place where people who have mental health problems have been cared for. And there's a long history and a considerable heritage value, as I understand it, to people in that area. So the first thing that's happening is actual consultation, where people have various different ways that they can tell our government what the value is. They can tell their stories about the property, their understanding of it, the things they really value from a heritage point of view, so that we know that. There have been some public meetings that are consultative, some workshops, and there's also an online process so people can go on the online, answer a questionnaire, and give their feedback that way. So that process is underway. There's also conversations with stakeholders, actual one-to-one interviews, and those are, as I understand it, underway as well. So we're going to get as good an understanding as we can about the heritage value of the lands. The actual land use planning will take that all into consideration. The Minister of Housing is responsible for that. And that will be an open and transparent process, and there have been no plans made as yet. The only thing that we do know is that people who were previously being cared for in the Riverview lands, who have had mental health problems, are almost all now being cared for in other places, often closer to their homes, and sometimes in a home-like setting as opposed to somewhere like Riverview. But I'm certainly aware, I've toured the property. It's a very large piece of property, very complex, with a lot of buildings on it. Some of them are very old and actually can't be used anymore. And I also took away from my visit that it's an important piece of property and very significant to people in, I'd say not only in that area, but really in British Columbia generally.
For the Minister of Energy and Mines and Minister responsible for housing, we are following through on our commitment to develop a heritage conservation plan for the lands, as we recognize the natural and cultural significance of the Riverview lands and the importance that community members place on its future. The heritage conservation plan will help guide our management of the lands and inform future land use planning. Rich Coleman, hope for the best in the future, and thank you for watching.